A final vote on impeachment just days away in the House. We'll talk with Indiana lawmakers and with Senators Todd Young and Mike Braun, plus one-on-one with Governor Eric Holcomb on his 2020 agenda. And we'll hear from Mayor Pete Buttigieg and the latest candidate to enter the race for Attorney General. It's all ahead this Sunday in Focus.
Exploring the issues that matter most in Indiana. This is In Focus with Dan Spehler.
Good morning. In the coming days, we're likely to see a historic vote in Congress on the impeachment of President Donald Trump, though it still appears he's facing likely acquittal in the Republican-held Senate. This week, I spoke with both of Indiana's senators, Mike Braun and Todd Young. I asked Senator Young if he'd decided how he would vote when the case comes to the U.S. Senate.
I don't think the process has been entirely fair. Impeachment process really began the day that President Trump was sworn into office. It was a party line vote to initiate an impeachment inquiry. That's not good for the country. Now, with all that said, I'm doing my due diligence. I am following the facts. I'm going to be a objective juror in a Senate impeachment trial, and I think that's really important so that I fulfill my duties as a United States Senator.
Some of this stuff that's being discussed, I think, was inappropriate on the part of the president, not impeachable.
Do you agree? Do you think the call was inappropriate in some regard?
Look, it's not what I would have done. I would not have. I would not have made the utterances that were reflected in that transcript. But the real question here is not whether I would have made it. I'm not the President of the United States. I wouldn't have engaged in, say, President Obama's fast and furious exercises. The real question is, does this constitute a high crime and misdemeanor? As a potential and likely juror in this matter, I can't speak to that right now.
In your mind, what does a fair trial in the Senate look like? How do you want to see the proceedings conducted?
Well, in my mind, now that we're looks like it's going to come to the Senate, I'm sure that they'll probably get enough votes on either one of the two articles of impeachment. I think where it has shown unfairness and lack of due process, especially during the behind-the-scenes proceedings within the House, that there'll be an effort here to make it a little different. I think this will be the first time that the president's going to be able to make his case.
There's talk that some in the GOP want this trial to move very quickly, with only a response from the White House, essentially, and no further testimony from some of the witnesses who testified in the House proceedings. You talked about wanting to do your due diligence, hearing the evidence. Would that truly be a fair proceeding in your view? Would you be comfortable with the process playing out that way?
Well, I want to make sure all the facts are in evidence. There doesn't seem to be significant disagreement as what the underlying facts are. So the impeachment managers, that is the Democrats who will be presenting the case on behalf of the prosecution in the impeachment trial, should, as we expect, this come to the Senate, they should be afforded the opportunity to present their evidence. The president should be afforded the opportunity through his counsel to offer a robust defense.
I think we've all heard the major points laid out there, and I think you could get into the details of the fact there was no quid pro quo. There was no direct testimony other than really what was heard elsewhere. Now, all of that says that yes, probably shouldn't be in the predicament to where we need to even discuss this. Also, the fact that it's preempted so much other stuff from getting done. But all of us will listen carefully to see if there's anything new that comes up, you know, once it gets here to the Senate.
Senators Mike Braun and Todd Young sharing their thoughts with us this week. More on our website. Meantime, here's the latest polling in recent days from Morning Consult and Politico. The numbers are steady, but a little higher than some of the other recent polls. In this poll, 50% of voters saying they support impeachment and removal, 41% do not. I spoke this week with Trevor Shirley from our Washington Bureau. All right, joined now by our Washington correspondent, Trevor Shirley. Trevor, it seems as if this is lining up to be a party line vote in the House for the most part, and certainly amongst Indiana's congressional delegation.
And that's exactly right, and really no surprise there. At this point, nobody's exactly showing their cards on how they're going to vote, but there is a really good likelihood that this will come down to a party line vote, especially with the lawmakers from Indiana. Speaking of which, we caught up with some of those lawmakers earlier this week. Let's take a listen.
I don't think, you know, that the inquiry has been done properly. I mean, some people are saying it's, you know, multiple times faster than the Clinton impeachment, and it's been done really quickly in a partisan way.
Impeachment continues to overshadow what I think is the real news of today, USMCA finally getting agreed to. This is hugely important to Hoosiers all the way across the district, whether they're in farming or manufacturing.
All right, Trevor, as we heard there, a lot of talk also about the USMCA and the timing here with that deal being announced the very same day as the articles of impeachment.
Yeah, and that was something that Democrats were really pushing for, not only to get the deal done, but to get it done in a way that they could go back to their constituents at home and say, look, we're not just completely absorbed with the impeachment process. This is proof that we're getting something done. So that was certainly a strategic move on the part of Democrats this week to get that passed so that they do have something to show that can show their constituents that they are working on things beyond just the impeachment proceedings.
What is this next week going to be like? Obviously, final vote on USMCA potentially, also the funding deadline here, and obviously this historic vote on impeachment in the House of Representatives.
Yeah, it's certainly going to be a busy week before Congress heads out for the holidays, and those are three major things that we're going to be looking at. Obviously, the funding deadline, the continuing resolution, is extremely important for both parties to get something passed because government funding runs out on Friday. If that doesn't happen, the government shuts down, something we went through just last year almost at the same time. So certainly something that both sides are trying to avoid. You mentioned USMCA. There's also a big push to get that nailed down and finalized. And then obviously there's the impeachment. That's going to be sucking up most of the oxygen in the room as we do expect to see a full vote on the House this week on that issue, sending it over to the Senate and setting us up for a trial that would probably happen sometime in January. So certainly a lot going on here in Washington this coming week.
Yeah, it's going to be an incredibly busy week and month ahead and year ahead there in the nation's capital. Trevor Shirley in our Washington Bureau, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
All right, meantime, Vice President Pence was here in Indianapolis Friday, coming home to take part in a campaign event for Governor Eric Holcomb, who, of course, is up for re-election next year. This week, the governor laid out his agenda for 2020 and spoke one-on-one with our Kayla Sullivan.